Hello friends, the first chapter of business studies is Nature and Significance of Management. What is this management all about? Is it a part of our daily life? Yes, we all manage something or the other. Like as a student, you manage studies, your parents manage the well-being of the family, a chief minister manages the state, a businessman manages the physical and material resource of his organization. Now what is the definition of this management? Management is the process of getting things done with the aim of achieving goals effectively and efficiently. Let's analyze the definition. Here, process means primary functions or activities like planning, organizing, staffing, directing, and controlling. These are done continuously. Now, let's see effectiveness. It means doing the right task at the right time with the aim of achieving goals. Efficiency means to get maximum output with minimum cost. Now, see an example. Suppose a sales manager is given a target to sell 1000 units in a month. For this, his staff demanded 5% increase in remuneration. The manager had no option than to increase the salary. So, the target is achieved but at a higher cost. Here, the sales manager is effective but not efficient. Management should maintain a balance between effectiveness and efficiency, as these are two sides of the same coin. I hope you would have understood the meaning of management. Now, try to understand its feature. The first feature is management is a goal-oriented process. Wherever a group of people work together and use physical and material resources, what they need is management. They use a proper process of planning, organizing, staffing, directing, and controlling to reach their set goal. For example, the goal of our central government is to set India free from COVID-19. For this, they are using proper management process with the help of state government, local government, and panchayat. The second feature is management is pervasive. Pervasive means omnipresent, which is present everywhere. Management is pervasive means it is present everywhere, whether it is a life of an individual, a family, a business or non-business organization like school, college, hospital or a political party. They need to manage things. So management is pervasive, or we can say it is universal. The third feature is management is a continuous process. All the functions of management like planning, organizing, staffing, directing, and controlling are done continuously by all the managers all the time. For example, if it is found that the production is less due to lack of workers, so the production manager will switch to staffing directly. Or if he finds that the quality of the product is not good because of inferior raw material, then he will switch to organizing function directly. So we can say that management is a continuous process. The fourth feature is management is multidimensional. There are three main dimensions. The first is management of work. It means what is to be done. Every organization performs some work. For example, a school imparts education, a doctor treats a patient. It is the management who translates this work into goal. For example, a school management will decide how many children can they teach in an academic session, and accordingly they arrange resources. The second dimension is management of people. It means who is to do it. Human resource is one of the main assets of an organization. Management has to get the work done from employees. These employees may have different types of need like hike in salary, promotion or job security. Management has to reconcile individual need for organizational goal. The third dimension is management of operation. It means how to do it. Every organization uses a production process to convert raw material into finished goods. For example, during the year 2020, due to COVID-19 lockdown period, almost all the school, colleges and coaching classes used more information technology to teach their students online. It means for this operative activity of teaching, they managed work and people. The fifth feature is management is a group activity. As we have seen in the last point that every member joins the organization for a different purpose. It is the job of management to combine individual effort for organizational interest. It requires teamwork and coordination. So we can say that management is a group activity, as together everyone achieves more as a team. The sixth feature is management is a dynamic function. Dynamic means a process or a system characterized by constant changes. A business organization is surrounded by external forces like social, economic, political, technological, and legal environment. These forces keep on changing. A management has to adapt itself to these changes. For example, due to technological development, even small shopkeepers started accepting online payment. During the year 2020, dynamic changes were seen in the plans and policies of government. Medium and large organizations permitted their employees to work from home. So we have learned that management is dynamic as it is affected by dynamic environmental forces. The seventh feature is management is an intangible force. Intangible means invisible or untouchable, like self-confidence, responsibility, or quality of a person or thing. You can see a manager but not his management quality. The presence of good management can be realized when goals are met, employees are happy and satisfied, there is teamwork, coordination, and healthy environment in the organization. If you like this video, like, share, and subscribe my channel. Thank you.